Hi. Before I start this video, I have to thank someone who donated the channel generously. His name is Michele. Thank you for your donation. I appreciate that. So that's why I decided to mention you in the video. Michele, mi bambino, grazie per la tua donazione, lo apprezzo. Tu sei mio amico, ma ora sei diventato un amico esclusivo del canale. Grazie ancora e tanti saluti. In this video, we're going to be talking something about the duty cycle. I've promised to do this video a long time ago. I've been telling you about the duty cycle, what it is, what do you actually do by turning the hex screw clockwise or counterclockwise, and so on. But now, because I got many questions about the duty cycle, how can it be done, and can it be done with a common multimeter? The answer is yes, it can be done. Okay, for this purpose, you will be needing a multimeter to do this operation, to do the duty cycle, but measuring voltage. It doesn't have to be like one you saw in my videos. It can be one like this, or like this, or maybe one like this. All these multimeters are very cheap. The important thing for them is, for example, this one, let me see. Okay, this one has an option between between AC and DC, amps, volts, etc. For example, if you have one like this and you choose DC amps, because DC volts, you need to put it to the lowest range, and in this case 20 volts, in order to get the most precise measurement. Or if we have one like this, same thing, because we want to measure up to 7 volts, you just put it to 20, and that's it. Here, this one, for example, adapts itself to all the conditions. And, of course, I'll show it later, the positive goes in number 3 on the X11 port, and the negative in number 2. Now, the next thing you need, it's going to be this thing, this guy, this hex 3 mils guy. And now I can't tell which voltage you're going to get and how much, but as you go for the precise settings, you will have to do it like this. You stick it in, you press the key, and now this is not, there is no movement here. For look at this now, for this much. This was barely a movement. That's for how much you're going to be turning, either clockwise or counterclockwise. For that much. And then you... But the only thing is that with a common multimeter, when doing this procedure, you don't have a percentage option. So you will have to do this other way. I had to do this option other way by measuring voltage instead of percents, because my multimeter betrayed me. In order to understand what a duty cycle is, those percents, you have 50% plus minus 5%. What it means? The percentage, that's actually voltage. How come? Well, Mercedes-Benz has one special formula for counting this option for percentage. It's actually the voltage on a special way. There is a special formula for this voltage, and it looks like this.
What
does this actually mean? This formula. This means that you measure the highest voltage on number 3 X11 port. Then you measure the voltage on your battery. As you divide these two, you then subtract 1 minus and the voltage you got, and the result you multiply by 100, and that's your percentage. Now, in order for you not to bother you what it means, and for every percent to do this formula, there is someone that already has done it, and this table looks like this. As you can see, the higher the voltage, the lower the percents. and vice versa. The lower the percents, the richer the mixture. Now, to repeat this again, in order to do your duty cycle, you must have three things fully operational. One of them is the potentiometer, the second one is the EHA, and the third one is the lambda probe. So, if you get a steady reading of 50%, that means that your lambda is either not operational or the engine has not still achieved the operating temperature. Now, what is extremely important by doing this? The extremely important thing by doing this is, as you turn the hex key, you must wait a bit, because now the ECU is in a learning mode. It either has to collect all the data from the sensors, or it has to do it itself. So you must give your ECU time to adapt to these new conditions. Now, there are many opinions. For example, someone says you turn the hex screw a bit, and then what you do, you press the throttle lever. No. Listen to me. By doing this, and when doing this, turn the hex key, but almost microscopically, just in order to feel, that there was a movement. And then you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then you press the throttle lever. And every time you do this, you must do this. Always wait. You will have to wait for the ECU to adapt to its new conditions. Not just to turn the key and then, well, what is this? What happened? Now there was no difference, and there is no difference in the engine operation. No, give the ECU time. That's extremely important. As I have mentioned already, there are many schools, let's say, or many opinions. Someone takes a multimeter, sets it to percents, and then he or she why not adjusts the duty cycle. Well, something more is important, and that's one more multimeter to be attached to the EHA, because as I've been talking about that, all the sensors that give information to the ECU, Then the ECU processes them and sends them to four crucial components. One of them is the ICV, the second one X11, the third one the diagnostics, if you have one, and the EHA. That's why the EHA is important then to determine the ideal differential pressure in the fuel distributor. And now there are many specs concerning many models. As for M102 engines, on idle, you will have to get the fluctuation around zero. A good value would be -2 amps. As for M116 and 117 engines, you will have to get even at 2000 RPM -7, from -5 up to -7 amps. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.